Hi, this is Cherokee with Make Your Habit Strong. And today is my day 34 of a 4 month journey for losing weight, which is part of a much larger goal that I have for myself. So I'm reporting in today with my daily video diary. So one thing I wanted to talk about today was number one, my exercise routine, where I do work all day, 5 days a week in an office. And how I'm able to exercise at work. I take my email, and every 2 hours from the time I walk in the door until the time I leave, I just set a timer to go off to get up and do. I have a series of calisthenics that I do. And that is a really helpful guide. And I stick to that every day. That is extremely consistent. And I was thinking about it today because the last few days I'm like, I don't feel like it, but I've just been doing it anyway because I think about how I would benefit from it. So what I do is when I don't feel like it, which is very common, especially if you're like, number one, if I'm actively working and you're like, you're on a roll, when my alarm goes off, sometimes I stop right away, sometimes I wait a few minutes. But the reason I do it is because it's a gift to myself. And I'm like, if I don't do it, I'm just going to sit here. I'm going to get more tired. I'm going to get more sleepy. And, I really have to put myself first. So that is a matter of me being able to put myself first. The other thing I think about is what am I going to actually do if I don't get up and do my exercises? What am I going to do instead? Just sit here? That's not going to help me. So those are the two things that I utilize to like get me up and just to do it anyway, whether I feel like it or not. And I do not leave the office until all five of them are done. So I have five times that I get up. So let's say the last one goes off at 4:30. If I don't get to it until five, I do it before I leave because when I come home, I have few other exercises that I do. So yeah, that's been working. And it's really just a matter of me saying, no, I'm going to get up because it's not normal or healthy to sit all day at a desk. Like my body is not, no one's body is designed to just sit in that shape at a desk all day. It's extremely unhealthy and it's taxing on the body, especially as we age in maturity. So, yeah, so there's that. And in terms of flexibility, that's something that I've really had to learn to infuse into my routine so that I don't have like this, stark, dogmatic way of trying to accomplish my goals. Because sometimes that can be, well, I guess for me, it can just make it a more painful process. So, I have in mind the things that I want to exercise, to do exercise wise, right? And then I usually start with a list or a spreadsheet of how I want it to go. And after you do it for a few weeks to a month, you already know during the course of the day what to do, right? So I already know what I have to do. Every time I get up, I do leg lifts, I do 33 releves, I do I practice a deep squat one. Like I want one perfect one, which I'm pretty much at now, so technically I can move it up to two. But yeah, so that's what I do at my desk. And then I walk around to get like, my blood circulating again. I also practice back bends. I do a set of three, and then I lift this really heavy book that I have at my desk. It feels like it's about 20 pounds or so. And so I lift that up over my head with both arms in that fashion. And I am now up to 17 reps. And so that's the series of five things that I do throughout the day. Yeah, and so it's just relaxing into it, I guess. Like initially when I first started this earlier this year, it seemed like to me it was more dogmatic and I don't know, sometimes things just happen. You might have an unexpected meeting or things happen, you know. But if you know in your mind what you have to accomplish, it can be so much more helpful than feeling like you need to, you know, stick to a rigid schedule. Because then if I can't get to it now, I'll get to it later. Like, I don't click off my message until I actually complete the task. And before I leave for the day, all five have to be completed, you know. So, you know, it's a learning curve. And I'm definitely learning as I'm going. And I think this is the third time I'm doing this kind of thing, which is video diarying. And I find diarying, video journaling. And I do find that it just helps me and makes my goal more refined each time. So at this point, this is I think the third time, I feel like I'm really like coming into my own and having fun with it. So anyway. I'm about to run out of time. That's what I wanted to report. Have a good night, and I will see you tomorrow.